So in the calendar, you can you need to have one or more teams or groups checked, and then you double click or right click in the calendar and select new practice for the team that you want to plan a practice for. So the practice window opens up. Let's go through the header. We'll add some time to the practice. You can write a label. Anything you write will also be stored in this list here, so I'm just going to select it. Same goes for location. You have this area here, which is a description, extra description for the locations. If you want the athletes to be reminded that they arrive X minutes before, you can write that in here. You have a color for the session. It's going to be the default color for the group, but you can override it. You can also write notes. And then you have this link here where you can click to add any kind of attachment, PDF or video to the session. You can select any document. You can also attach a form. For example, if you want your players to register RP, your training load, X minutes after the end of the session, you can do that. Then you can have this default for all team sessions or any form really. So that's a powerful feature. The last option here is override group settings. And that just means that for this specific practice, I might choose not to use the group settings. Maybe I want to hide the practice content just for this practice, then I could do that here. To add drills, you go over here to the right side where you have your drill collection. It's the same drill collection that you can browse and manage here on the left under your collections. And you have all of the same functions, for example, the search bar and which is good to use because you can write shorthand here and find anything that you want. You can also search by tags if you're tagging your drills. For example, here you have the warm-up tag. But notice this, I could also just write warm-up here in the search bar because it also searches in the tags. Important thing to understand is that when you're planning practice, sometimes you might not have the drill in your drill collection and then you just want it to grow organically. So just right here, click create new drill and add them on the fly. Regarding adding, you can drag and drop, but an even faster way is to just double click on the drills that you want to add. That's how easy it is to add the drills. Now let's go over to the drill section here. I'm going to hover over this drill and remove it by pressing the X here. I'm going to move this one down. I can do that either by using the arrows here or just having it selected and using the arrows here on the bottom bar. So now I have the drills in the order I want to perform them. Then we go to the minutes field. Just put the focus here, go to the keyboard and write, I'm writing 10 minutes here. Now instead of scrolling down and going with the mouse here, don't do that. Just on the keyboard, press the down arrow on the keyboard and then you can write something here by clicking up and down arrows. You go between these minute fields. When I entered the time, the minutes, the duration of the session was automatically updated. So you don't really need to fill this in if you're filling in minutes for your drills. That said, after you filled in the minutes for drills, if you can override this, so could put this to 60 if I wanted to. Once you've added drills, you can change anything here regarding the text, and that won't change the drill. So let's say I go in here and write Team A, Bob, Joe. This is only changing the text on the practice, on this practice. Maybe I decide to delete these coaching points here for this practice and so on. Or you can also change what picture you want to have if you're printing it out. So you can just click on the arrow keys here to go between. You can press these little buttons. There are two videos connected to this drill. I could click here to view them or click here to view the diagram itself or just press on the diagram. If you want to change the drill template itself, you can hover over and press open here. So this is where you could actually go in and change the drill. Now let's go to the bottom bar and see, go through all the options there. So the first button here is the attendance. If there's default attendance on the practice, these would all be checked. If not, you can just press this button to check them all and press again to uncheck, but you would check them all and then just check away the ones who weren't there. You can write a comment. That's just for the coaches. You can also see comments from athletes if they were allowed to mark their attendance themselves and maybe added a comment. You have participants here. It's a nice feature. Sometimes you can see here how he was. It's gray here. That means he's part of this group, but he's like a player on loan from another group. Maybe he's an optional player in this group. The way to do that is that in your teams, you can add somebody from another group to this team, and then you can just press this little I here, which makes them optional. So that means they're not really participating in the sessions unless you add them in the participants button right here. You got to message participants that you can decide to message everyone involved in this session. Already showed you the up and down functions. One thing there though, you could, now I'm holding down shift on the keyboard and you can see I've multi-selected these two drills here. They both have a blue border, and then I can press the up arrow to move them both. Add split, let's click add split. Now I just add it at the bottom. I might move it up, of course. But you can split up the session in as many parts as you want. And here you need to use the drag and drop. So let's say I wanted to drag something over here. So that means part of my group can be doing this while another part might be doing this. And you can even select exactly the athletes you want to be in this section and which ones you want to be here. And this is all shown in the app. Yeah, remove is just, it's just the same as the X. Although you could multi-select and do remove. You can have the practice window in two types here. This is a standard one, the visual one, but you can also, if you want to have it super compact, you can use the timetable. Then you just see it in a different way. You have the notify button. It's similar to the message, but it doesn't seem to send a message. It just sends a push notification with a message from you to coaches, athletes, or family members, or any combination thereof. And then lastly, you have the print button. You will have your team logo here. And then you have different settings. You can really play around with these settings and have it as compact as you want. And here you can either print it out or save it as a PDF. Now let's see how it looks on the phone. Here's the session I just created. We can go in and see how it looks. We're going to see the splits, the plan. You can click on the drills. You can see the diagrams, the videos, the coaching points. We can change the minutes here. We can see the members of the session, the coaches and the athletes. We can click here to register the attendance. You can press the pluses here to write comments. You can click on the three little buttons here and select modify practice. The practice has two parts. It's the plan itself, the drills. And then you can also go over here to info if you want to change the label, location, notes, duration. You can hold down, you can use drag and drop here to change the order of the drills. Drag and delete. You can also click here on this button here to go over to the drill section. You can click on these little buttons to add the drills to your plan. Or simply hold down and drag them to where you want. You can also click on the folder button here to see all of your folders and find drills that way. You can click the plus button here so you can actually create that practice from scratch. But just try it out. Thank you for listening.